I'm Jodie Reseigh O'Brien, and today we're at Mount Eba Station in the geographical centre of South Australia with owners Peter and Margie Whittlesea and Paul Cousins. We're going to explore what technologies and best practice management practices have been used on the station and the benefits these are bringing to the business.
Here we are, we're at Mount Eba Station. We are the centre of South Australia. We purchased it with two other parties back in 2015, as in Paul and Michelle Cousins and Hayden and Michelle Whittlesea as well. We had 11,500 head of stock and 300 or 400 head of cattle. We've now had it for 6.5 years now, and we are now carrying 25,000 sheep and around about 300 head of cattle.
At Mount Eba Station, as part of best practice management, they prick scan their ewes where they wet dry, and they also scan a percentage of the mob for multiples.
We prick test them at straight off shears, and we'll take the ones that are in lamb, we'll go one way, the ones that are dry or undetectable will go the other way. So the ewes with the lamb will go out to their paddocks and lamb out there, and the other ewes that are dry at the time, they'll go out into another paddock and we'll put the rams back with them. We're only taking the ewes off that are in lamb, we're not doing twins here, up here. Too advanced to do. We did have a couple of mobs last year, but that if you got all twins in one mob, that's probably too many for each paddock. So we just did a percentage of about 100 to 150 ewes of each mob. So that gives us an idea of how many multiples we've got, so we can work out whether, you know, how many we're losing. A lot of these ewes have only got another 3 weeks to a month to go before they start lambing, so I want to get these done as quick as we can and get them back out in the paddock and settle them down. It's a big bonus for us, as I said before, you've got ewes lambing at a certain time so you can tail them there, but it's not for everybody. It works well for us because I'm a scanner and half owner, so that which I can be up here all the time, but on other people's on station, bigger stations place, it is very difficult because I can't be there the whole time scanning throughout the shearing. So that is one of the problems that you get. You really probably have to get them back in and scan them after shearing, which is, it makes it a bit more difficult. As a scanner, really do need a good race to just keep them moving. Otherwise, it's hard on everybody, and it's not an enjoyable job. So, as long as you've got a good draft and good places to take them away. Our prick testing has boosted our lambing. We get a lot more lambs on the ground because all those dry ewes, we get them in lamb. So, that could be another extra 10%, and you work out another 10% over your flock. It's quite a lot of money. This year we EID'd all our rams before, wandered them all before we put them out in the paddocks. And then when they're coming back in now, we put them back through the scanner again, just the wand, and just to see how many of the rams have come back, or just work out how many rams are still out in the paddock.
Peter and Margie Whittlesea both have gyrocopter licences, which they use for mustering and checking waters.
We use a gyrocopter to muster, especially the western side where it's quite scrubby. It's crucial to have a plane in the air to be able to find the animals and try and mob them up, especially once again this year when there's moisture everywhere and the heavy dews and a bit of rain and puddles everywhere. The livestock tend to spread out quite a bit, so that whereas in summer or when we're perhaps drier, they'll be gathered more around the water points. Turning waters off to trap sheep, we're trying to avoid doing that if we can. Once again, a little bit of stress and don't need to be pushing the envelope on any of that. So the animal husbandry and the gyro backs all of that up or helps us gather those animals in a more efficient manner. It's a fairly cheap aircraft to run, and I believe it's quite safe if you do everything well on it. A place this size, like we're 65 k's to the north and 65 k's to the west, so it's a big L-shaped block. The gap between the whole lot's probably 160 k's. So for those people that perhaps want to understand the rainfall event that comes through, like it's like a little down south, a little town's only 20 k's away, and they might have 50 mils and another one might only have 30 mils and they're only 10 k's apart. So those strips can happen through our property a lot. Now, we've got rain gauges out there, probably 5 or 6, but in an area of this size, you don't really cover the where it has fallen. So by flying straight after a rain, from a management perspective, I can see where the wetter areas are, what's going on, and it sets us up a little bit, like an extra 30 or 40 mils in an area on the next program. So we've got 3 main campaigns every year. Shearing's the big one where we do the big shuffle. Then we've got landmarking in the middle in August, and then we've got crutching out the other side in the middle of October, sort of early November. So the crutching and the shearing one in particular, I can do little shuffles. So if I've known that there's an area that had 30 or 40 more mils of rain, you know, earlier, when we do those shuffles or handling the stock, I can just sort of move a little bit of stock, not a lot, but to those areas to help spread the load. So the total grazing pressure across the property is evenly spread. And that's the idea of the water points that we've put in too.
Yeah, so when we purchased Mount Eba back in 2015, there wasn't a lot of water structure infrastructure here. All at the northern end of the property, we had no water at all. As we know, stock only graze, you know, walk out 4 or 5 Ks. So we've got this big paddock with this one little water point here. So the rest of the paddock is not being utilised for grazing purposes. So what we've decided to do is to expand our water infrastructure. We were able to put in a lot more poly pipe. So most of our paddocks now have roughly between 2 or 3 troughs per paddock is what we're trying to work on. So the stock can actually graze the bush evenly. So we're trying to stop the overstocking at the water points is what we're trying to do. So the stock will now evenly distribute around the paddock or where there's feed, and they haven't got far to go for water as well.
At Mount Eba Station, they use water telemetry. They have cameras on their troughs, tanks and dams. They also have auto shut off on their pumps where they can be remotely turned on and off.
This is our setup in our office, of which we've got quite a decent sized screen. And what we've got here is all a list of all our water points right through. So these are all our water points that we've currently got cameras on. Pete comes in here every afternoon and checks the cameras. So this is 65 k's away. So for us to be able to log into that 65 k's away, we can actually see that there's no water issues sitting there at the moment, which is also really good. Our 2 tanks pump is approximately also 65 k's away from us. And this pump here is actually in one of our big dams at the northern end of the property, also around about 60 k's. So all we need to do is come on here. It's got 2 tanks pump, pump's currently off, and all we need to do is click it to turn on. So that one there's, that gives us a really good indication that the water's pumping, because this is one of our main water tanks here as well. And it gives you a good indication that you've got water flowing and it's also full as well. Another thing we do is when we have rains up north, we jump on here as well and have a look and see if there any water's been lying around or anything like that. So yeah, that's always a good thing. If we can't jump in the gyro and go for a fly, we can, you know, jump onto the cameras and check up north and see if there's any water lying around. And you know, if there is after a rain, well, we know we've had rains up there because we can't always get up there because it's too wet. For this setup here, it's all operated with Wi-Fi. So Mike Hayes from Intuit came in and set up all the Wi-Fi around the property for us to be able to, yeah, pretty much make it work.
Okay, so here we are at the lookout pump that we've just seen on the computer in at the office. We've just driven down here. It's about a 5-6 K drive, might be a little bit further than that to get down here. It does supply the house and other paddocks with water. It is one of the most used pumps on the property that we've got at the moment. Due to shearing, we've got a lot of stock that have come in at the moment as well, so that's why it is running at the moment. We could be using the solar because it is nice and bright and what have you, but obviously it's just been decided to keep it running for a bit more pressure to come through to keep everything topped up while we are shearing.
during summer in particular, we've got to get around to those water points twice a week. We can get some extreme weather up here during summer, and if we're not back there within 3 or 4 days of us leaving that site the first time, those sheep are perishing by the time we get back the next time. So you've got to do it twice a week. This way, we cut it back, a lot of them are on dams, so the salty water, we've got to clean those troughs physically once a week just because of the salt content in the troughs. But a lot of those setups of those cameras, we've actually got set up now, it's a live picture. I can check the tank, I can check the trough, what's actually going on there. So I could take, I don't know, calculated risks is right, but right up, yeah, we don't probably have to do that water run this week. Or we certainly have cut back massively on the amount of vehicle travel. Like, I haven't done any big figures on it, but once again, not rocket science. You don't have to work it out too hard that 65 Ks might be the furthest point, but you're probably gonna do that water run would be 180 kilometers. Up there, if we're only doing it perhaps once a week, if not perhaps once every 2 weeks, because the cameras are solving the problem, massive savings on all of those fronts. Once, yeah, a bit of money to set up, but once it's set up, and we've been now doing that, what are we into our fourth year of that? So we just allocate, which is, doesn't have to be done in one go, guys, just niggle away at it. So we'll allocate probably 10 to 15 grand a year is what we've been allocating, and we're gradually getting all the cameras set up. So it just helps those causes considerably.
Thank you to Peter, Margie and Paul for hosting us, showing us their technology and best practice management strategies at Mount Eba Station. If you'd like to know more about the red meat and wool growth program, you can go to our website.